external. At the internal level, the meditation involves pramadhi, sakshi, viveka. At the external level, meditation involves nama rupa, sad or prameya, sad viveka. And here also we saw that in pramadhi sakshi viveka, first we make use of certain vrittis as a help to arrive at the sakshi. And when we make use of the vrittis, like kama, krodha, lobha, any vritti, ghata vritti, pata vritti, and with the help of the vritti, I ascertain myself as the sakshi of the vritti. That is, this vritti comes, I am. Before this vritti came, I am. After this vritti goes, I am. Thus I see that vritti has arrival and departure. Worry comes and goes, anger comes and goes, remembrance comes and goes, but I continue. Thus, with the help of the vritti, I arrive at vritti sakshi. Vritti moolama, vritti sakshi ki varadhe. This is called Drishyanuvidha Savikalpa Samadhi. So at this stage, vritti is a medium, a guidance, a help to arrive at the sakshi. And after arriving at the sakshi, I knock off the vritti. That is called Shabdanuvidha. Removal of the vritti. Like a pole vault jumper making use of the pole vault to go up. Using the pole vault and going up is like Drishyanuvidha. Dropping the pole vault and going to the other side is Shabdanuvidha. Falling on the ground is Nirvikalpa. Sriyabhaja, pole vault that. Internal pole vault. Thus, vritti is the pole. Making use of the vritti pole, I come to the sakshi side. Having come to the sakshi side, I drop the vritti pole, and when I am established in the sakshi, it is Nirvikalpa Samadhi. Similarly, at the external level also, nama rupa will be like the pole. With the help of nama rupa, I will come to the sat adhisthanam. And this is called Drishyanuvidha. And afterwards, I drop the nama rupa and turn my full attention on the sat part alone, that is Shabdanuvidha. Why is it called Shabdanuvidha? To turn the attention, I use certain words. Clue words are used, therefore Shabdanuvidha. It is not necessary that you should use these words, but the author is giving certain clue words like akhanda, akhanda, ekaratam, etc. They are all just like mantras or tips. With the help of those tips, we drop the nama rupa and mind gets absorbed in the substance. And this dropping the nama rupa with the help of certain words is called shabdanuvidha. And then total absorption in that is nirvikalpa. Thus, from vritti we come to chaitanyam, from nama rupa we come to sat. Chaitanyam is inside, sat is outside. Seeing the chaitanyam is antara dhyanam, seeing the sat is bahya dhyanam. But incidentally, we have to note a point here, that even though in the external meditation we arrive at the sat, but there also that sat should be later identified as chit. Otherwise our mind will continue to be extrovert. Bahya samadhi, in the beginning only it should be extrovert. Once you arrive at the sat, from sat we have to again come to chit disakshi. That I, the chit alone, and the sat which is in and through all the nama rupa. So these are the six meditations pointed out. Antara Drishyanuvidda Savikalpa Samadhi, Antara Shabdanuvidda Savikalpa Samadhi, Antara Nirvikalpa Samadhi, Bahya Drishyanuvidda Savikalpa Samadhi, Bahya Shabdanuvidda Savikalpa Samadhi, and Bahya Nirvikalpa Samadhi. I know you know, but just to make it thorough, I repeat it. No, we will only repeat it. Then the author said, Yetaihi Shaddhihi Samadhihi Naye Kalam Nirantaram. For a Vedantic student, after Shravanam and Mananam, no other work except this, he says. Of course, he keeps a sannyasi in view, Grihasthaka, as much as possible, so he will class Pudanam. Often as possible, this meditation has to be practiced. Okay, adanala enna agum, the phalam is said in the next shloka. Dekhabhimani galite, vijnate paramatmani, yatra yatra mano yati, tatra tatra samadhayah. There's a correction. The second line, last word, samadhayah. It should be fourth dha, samadhayah. So what is the benefit? Twofold benefit. One is Deha Abhimana Tyaga, giving up of the bodily identification. Because when there is body identification, there will be kaumaram, yauvanam, jara will be there. Not only kaumaram, yauvanam, jara of our own body, we will have to see the kaumaram, yauvanam, jara of Abhimanam is more, attachment will be more. And when attachment will be more, anxiety, worry, tension, etc. will be more, which alone is called samsara. And if the samsara must be reduced, attachment should be reduced. If attachment has to be reduced, dehabhimana must come down. I should see all these bodily relations are temporary at the nama-rupa level. It is like various bubbles coming and going. There is no question of permanent body or permanent relationship. This tyaga is the phalam of the meditation. Deha abhimani galite. Why deha abhimana becomes less and less? As long as I stand as a pramata, dehabhimanam will be more. When I stand as sakshi, dehabhimanam will be less. Because pramata alone is intimately connected to the body because of purva janma karma. Pramatru deha sambandha is stronger. And therefore, as long as I am a pramata, deha abhimanam will be there. When I see pramata as something different from me, the sakshi, then deha abhimana becomes reduced. And then what will happen? Vijnate paramatmani. Then the paramatma jnanam also will become intimate aparoksha. How do you say so? The reason is this. See, sakshi alone is totally identical with Paramatma. Chit alone is totally identical with Paramatma. Pramata is not identical with Paramatma. Do you remember who is Pramata? Adukula Adumarthu Bhavirthana Bhavirthalam. Pramata is nothing but the mind with reflected consciousness. Sabhasa Buddhi is never equal to Paramatma. Why? Because Buddhi also is finite. The abhasa in the buddhi also is finite. Finite pramata can never be identical with all pervading paramatma. Okay, then what about sakshi? Sakshi is neither the buddhi nor the abhasa, chidabhasa. Sakshi is nothing but the chit itself. And the chit, the awareness, is identical with the Paramatma. And therefore, always sakshi brahmanoho eva aikyam, pramatru brahmanoho aikyam na sambhavati. If that is so, suppose I ask you a question, are you identical with Brahman or not? What will be the answer? Suppose you ask 10 people, are you identical with Paramatma or not? So one day in our ashrama course, Swamiji Pradangara straight away, are you Paramatma or not? Nanna padikare, nanna kashat edukare, nanna nootsu edukare, are you Paramatma or not? One answer only. But the name Kundila Anugrahi. Yes or no is the question. The answer will depend upon what? Whether you are taking yourself to be Pramada or you are taking yourself to be Visakshi. If you stand as Pramada, you can never say, I am identical with Paramatma. You will say, ennodu sakshi irukkuvanga ullukulla. Edo sakshi ondukku. That sakshi is identical with Brahman. I am not identical. But suppose within 6 meditations, you have convincingly and strongly understood that I cannot be the temporary Pramada, but I am the Sakshi, then you can boldly say, Aham Paramatma Asmi. The Pramada has Deha Sambandha, it will undergo the Prarabdham for some time and it will perish off. But Aham Paramatma Asmi, Mayeva Sakalam Jatam, May Sarvam Pratishthitam, May Sarvam Dayam Yati. Thus, the advantage of Nididhyasanam is, I can learn to remain as Sakshi more and more. I will be spontaneously taking myself as a Sakshi. And more the spontaneity, the more the Purnatvam. Otherwise, I have to intellectually convince my Purnatvam, all the time feeling a Purnatvam. I have to tell Sakshi is Purnaha, Sakshi is Purnaha, Aham Apurnaha will come. The phalam of this meditation is, I will no more say Sakshi is Purnaha, I will say Aham Purnaha. This is called Vijnanam. You are telling that in the first person. What is jnanam? Sakshi purna. Enakku nare problem illa irukke. Aham apurna. Sakshi purna. So when you say sakshi purna, it is jnanam. Jnanam na puriyarudhu. Because I understand this is mind, Kitabhasa is there, Sitti is reflecting. Romba nanna arithi classes illu sattinke dvara kuduruve. So therefore, everything is understood clearly, but I cannot say Aham Purna, Pandyanakuda Aham. So thus, Sakshi Purna is Jnanam, Aham Purna is Vijnanam. Paroksha Jnanam, Jnanam, Aparoksha Jnanam, Vijnanam. Purna Asti Jnanam, Purna Asmi Vijnanam. அதுக்கு என்ன பண்ணணும்? ஏதை சமாதி விஹி சக்தி. Practice this, then it will become spontaneous. And thereafter what? Since the mind is spontaneously established in Sakshi Swarupam, no more effort is necessary. He needs మనోయాతి. Wherever the mind goes, tatra tatra samadhayah. All of them are meditations for him. He need not sit with closed eyes, withdrawing the sense organs. Nothing is necessary. Whatever he does, sarvatha vartamanodi sayogi mayi vartate. Then you may ask, how can you call it meditation? He is doing vyavahara. Meditation is not dependent on whether you are doing vyavahara or not. Meditation is not dependent on closing the eyes. Meditation is not dependent on sitting in Padmasana. What is the definition of meditation? Mind being absorbed. Mind not even absorbed. Mind being aware of the adhisthanam is meditation. Even during vyavahara, if in your subconscious mind this awareness is there, all these are vyavaharikam. Pramatra prameya vyavaharas will continue. Some of them will be successful, some of them will be failure. Thus pramatra prameya vyavaharas will go on. I am the unaffected adhisthanam. This remembrance is there in the subconscious mind. He is a meditator only. That's why I give you this example. Suppose you are traveling by the train. All through your travel, you will remember the destination. Not that all the time you are sitting and telling, I am going to Delhi, I am going to Delhi, I am going to Delhi. No. Whatever vyavahara you do during the train journey, that will not make you forget the fundamental goal, and that is the destination Delhi. You may get down in between stations, you may buy vadai and dosai and all those things. ட்ரெயின் தான் நிறைய சாப்பிடுவோம், வேற வேலையும் இல்லி வந்துடும், ஒன்றும் இல்லைன்னா வாய்ப்பு வேலை. ஸோ தேர்ஃபோர் யூ மே பை, யூ மே கிவ் மணி, யூ மே டேக் பேக் சேஞ்சஸ். யுவர் மைண்ட் இஸ் டூயிங் ஆல் ஆஃப் தம், பட் இன் தி சப்கான்ஷியஸ் தேர் இஸ் அன் அவேர்னஸ், ஐ ஆம் ஏ ட்ரெயின் டிராவலர். தேர்ஃபோர் ஒன் பார்ட் ஆஃப் தி மைண்ட் இஸ் ஆல்வேஸ் அவேர். இன் தி சேம் வே, ஏ ஜ்ஞானி இஸ் நாட் going to sit all the time and tell, I am Sakshi, here is Sat, I am Sakshi, here is Sat. No. He knows Satchidatma Ahamasmi. And I am doing Vyavahara with Pramatri Vesha. And for this Vesha, you are all putting on Prameya Vesham. Thus with Pramatri Prameya Vesham, the drama is going on. In the green room, I am neither Pramata nor Prameyam. I am Pramatru Prameya Adhisthana Bhuta Sachit Sakshi Asmi. This constant awareness is called Yatra Yatra Manoyati Tatra Tatra Samadayah. Continuing. Vidyate hridaya granthihi chidyante sarva samshayah kshiyante chasya karmani tasmin drishte paravare. So here also, the dhyana phalam is being given. 30 and योग्यत सर्ग एषां साम्येष्ठितं मनः निर्दोषं हि तमं ब्रह्म तस्मात् ब्रह्मणि तेर्थिताः यवर इन समबुद्धि. And here, not only the author is giving the phalam, he is doing an intelligent thing. Instead of giving the phalam in his own words, he is quoting from an Upanishad. That is Mundaka Upanishad. So twofold purposes are served. One, the phalam is given